This is a quick video of how I solved a couple problems I was having with my Skywalker, mainly during night flying. One problem is with my pan setup. I have my pan servo controlled by a rotating dial on my Futaba transmitter, and it does not return to center on its own. In order to recenter the camera, I would normally have to look down at my TX to center the dial in order to tell that I'm looking straight out in front of me again. I solved this problem easily enough by mounting a tiny bit of yellow tubing directly in front of my flight camera to mark dead center. Now this works fine in the daytime, but at night there is usually not enough light to see the yellow tube. Flying at night can be difficult enough without the added complexity of not being able to tell if I'm looking out the front of my Skywalker or not. This clip is from a recent flight where I'm trying to line up for my runway, and at the same time I am trying to recenter my camera. A very annoying situation that can also be downright dangerous. Another small issue I wanted to solve is how to tell the position of my multi-switch selector as I advance through all 7 output ports. These 7 ports are like light switches, turning 7 different things on, including my nav LEDs and strobe, and after the 7th is turned on, another flick of the switch, everything shuts off. The first 3 flips turn on all my nav lighting, the 4th flip turns on my strobe light, the 5th and 6th flip turn on power to my starboard and port accessory items, the 7th flip turns on my new siren, and a final flip turns everything off again, ready for a fresh cycle. The problem is, in the air, when at a distance, there's no way I can tell what is on and what is not. I could be blazing around through the sky with my siren blaring and not even know it. What I've been doing is panning over and looking out over one of my wings and flipping through the 7 positions until my wing LED lights go out. When they go out, I know that everything else has been shut off and I am at position 0. Then I can begin cycling through again, turning on the things I want. This is a fairly simple workaround, but to make it even simpler, here's the solution. I installed a rear view mirror at lower center so that I can see both wing undersides without panning. If my wing LEDs are off, then I know I am at position 0 on my multi-switch, and all 7 accessories are also shut off. This way I can focus on flying and looking straight ahead, rather than having to fumble with a pan servo while flipping through the 7 multi-switch positions. The mirror I am using is actually a fishing lure that I bought from Walmart. It was only $1.25. I didn't do anything to it other than snip off the shiny part and glue it in place with some hot glue. The lure is very light, probably a gram or so, or even less. I wanted something with a convex shape so that I could see as much of each wing as possible. Now I could fly along at night or in the daytime, and I can tell with a quick glance if my nav lighting and strobe light are on. And I can also tell when everything is shut off. Now this also solves the other problem I've been having, which is centering the pan camera at night. Now I just look for the red and blue in my rearview mirror. Normally red and blue flashing in your rearview mirror is a cause for concern, especially while driving, but for me, it's a sign that all is well, and then I am much more visible to possible full-size airplane pilots. I hope this helps give you guys some ideas of your own. If you like this video, be sure to subscribe to my channel because there's a lot more on the way.
And I wish I did have a pair. Well, the beaver one slept for 7 days and again.